something's turned off. And, like, I don't have part of me anymore.
It's a murderous kind of look that you really... It's chilling. It's absolutely chilling.
I don't remember coming after anyone with a knife. I'm not saying it didn't happen. I'm just saying I can't remember. I get afraid of they're gonna hurt me badly.
Yeah.
On this visit, the Wallenbergs look like any other Southern California family. But getting them to moments like these has been anything but easy.
There are days when you're fighting constantly.
One moment, it's the invisible demons that have haunted her two older daughters. The next,
it's the insurance company or the school district or the services.
She is gone to the end of the world for us, and I can't wish for a better mom.
But much of the time, Jennifer Wallenberg feels like a failure. In her darkest moments, she fears the worst.
Every time I hear on the news about another sort of rampage like Virginia Tech or Columbine, it breaks my heart because I think I could easily be that parent. I could easily be the one who said, I have tried for years to get them help.
Practically since birth, Brenna, now 13, and Ailish, 12, have suffered. Both girls have been diagnosed with manic depression, which triggers unimaginable mood swings. They've also been haunted by voices and images no one else can see. Doctors call that psychotic mental illness bordering on schizophrenia.
No.
Horrible hallucinations. She sees animals coming out of the walls.
When the hallucinations started triggering violent outbursts,
she would grab the steering wheel while I was driving and try to drive us into oncoming traffic.
Jennifer had no choice but to send Brenna to a residential psychiatric ward at a very young age.
I had to be in the adolescence unit at 8 or 9.
Not long after, her younger sister followed. This rip screen on Ailish's third-story bedroom window is a painful reminder. Ailish first tried to kill herself when she was just 6 years old.
Because the voices were telling her that she needed to jump out the window.
By 8, Ailish's illness drove her to become dangerous to her family. On one occasion,
she's come after me with a knife. When I hid the knife, she said, "That's okay, I'll just pour boiling water on you while you sleep."
I've been through some pretty hard times.
Ailish doesn't remember attacking her mom with a knife, nor does she remember mutilating a blonde-haired doll that resembled younger sister Kieran.
I guess our brains have learned to block out certain things so we don't have to remember them.
Kids struggling with severe mental illness are often sent out of state for months or even years. The closest long-term residential facility willing to treat Brenna and Ailish was in Texas. Ailish was especially traumatized.
When I left, she was clinging to me and they had to peel her off. And I just thought, I don't know if I'm doing the right thing. I have no idea.
But Jennifer felt she had no choice.
We were in fear for our lives every single day.
3 years apart kept the family alive. But it's taken a toll on Ailish and Brenna, where they were treated.
There's a lot of people that are older than you, and they tell you things that you shouldn't know.
I was shown things I had never seen before, because I had always been a kid.
Brenna shares few details of being institutionalized, but she says she often feels a part of her is missing.
Probably being away for so long, I just lost it. I don't know.
Brenna and Ailish have been home since June. Medication helps keep their illnesses in check.
I take pills every morning and every night, and I don't hallucinate or as much as I usually do.
Ailish puts it a little differently. The antipsychotic pill, she says,
make me not nuts. Simply, that's what they do.
Jennifer is relieved to have her daughters home. Kieran, who is often the victim of her sister's illnesses, is learning to adjust and understand.
I do sometimes feel guilty because friends come easily and opportunities come easily for me, but my sisters, nothing really comes easily for them.
But there are hopeful signs things are starting to look up.
Bye, honey. Have a good day.
It was a victory for Jennifer to see Ailish able to head back to school and to see Brenna, who'd been so depressed, experienced sheer joy as she recently rode on a roller coaster. The Wallenbergs decided to share their story because they feel mental illness has wrongly been shrouded in secrecy.
I think that as a society, we need to get on board with the idea that this is just as much of an illness as cancer.
And I know cancer can kill you, but so can this.
Ailish's advice to anyone who wants to help.
Just listen. And don't doubt what we can do and help us get better doctors and try to help us blend in with everyone else.
Brenna hopes people aren't scared by what she's shared, that they'll see her difficult revelations in a positive light.
We're not normal, but we want you to think we're normal. But when we tell you that we aren't, then you know that we're truly trying to be friends with you.
I will fight for them forever. I will not give up on them. I'm never going to give up on them.